Today is all about payment service companies. There are two that I really, really like, and both of them still have a lot of growth to do. Square, which has grown 238% this year, and PayPal, which has grown 100% this year. But if you had $1,000, where would you put it, Square or PayPal? Stay with me to find out how much more they have to grow in 2021. Hey everyone, it's Ravi here. I am an investor. This is for educational purposes only. I'm giving you the market updates and sharing my stock market picks. This is not financial advice in any way, and it's for entertainment purposes. Also, please click that like button as it helps me with the YouTube algorithm and it doesn't cost you a thing. And if you enjoy staying on top of the market news and want to get the latest on any stock news, then be sure to subscribe right down there and let's begin. The concerns surrounding the new digital environment for payments and transfers of money are very similar to earlier developments in the banking industry, like the introduction of the ATM. The payment system is growing and evolving. There's no doubt about that. Payments platforms are definitely becoming the future of financial transfers of all kinds based on security, fidelity, speed, cost efficiency, data richness, and also added value. Fast, efficient, modern, and flexible payment processing systems are less expensive than the old legacy systems and include enhanced data carrying capabilities that do provide us a way to enrich the data to add real value in form of enhanced customer experience, automated tasks like reconciliation. So a lot of efficiency plays here. Data has also become a currency because money and finance is just information and it's the bedrock of the future state of the payments industry. Payment services like PayPal and Square are, I believe, going to play important roles in the future of banking systems. And because of the role that they will play, they will be a good investment opportunity for the longer term growth. There have been numerous reports charting the gradual move away from cash, including the one that was done in January, which said several European and Asian nations will be cashless this decade. And with the US also moving in that direction, and the pandemic only accelerated this trend. A report from Square said the number of its merchants that were completely cashless rose from 5% before the pandemic to 13% in August. And then another June report from MasterCard found that roughly 70% of consumers say the shift to digital payments is permanent. This is huge news, and this is why we're talking about these two high growth companies today. So let's start with PayPal. PayPal is such a great long-term stock and that I think you should consider buying it now before the price gets too high. The service that PayPal offers, sending and receiving cash and payments online, have certainly been more critical than ever due to the pandemic. With people staying home and social distancing, the usage of PayPal has skyrocketed. In fact, PayPal is coming off one of its best quarters ever with a 25% increase in revenue year over year to $5.5 billion and 121% increase in earnings. The company also posted another record in the $247 billion in total payments volume in the quarter, which was up 36% year over year. The total payment value is the total value of payments completed through the platform. They were a 4 billion payment transaction, which is up 30%. And PayPal's Venmo payment app did $44 billion in total payment value, which is up 61% year over year. Also, they added 15.2 million net new accounts in the quarter, which is up 55%. And the company now has 361 million active accounts. These numbers have also boosted the stock price over 100% year to date. And there are a few good reasons why this is not a short-term market reaction, why it's actually a good idea to buy PayPal now before the price rises even higher. The PayPal chart shows that relatively in the past few months, the stock has been trading flat with some swings up or down. And the relative strength index is also showing that the stock is not overbought and it's going more on the oversold side, in my opinion. I think this is because new IPOs have pushed some money into those industries like Airbnb, DoorDash, Palantir versus into strong companies like PayPal. I do believe it's about 15% overvalued at the current price. I really like PayPal and would double down around the $175 to $185 range. However, at $220, it's still good for the long term, but you're paying a premium on the adjusted price to earnings of 81.7. For education though, the adjusted price to earning basically means that it's adjusted for the net cash or debt on the balance sheet as if all the cash were used to buy back stock and all the debt were used paid by issuing stock. So PayPal stock price is likely going to continue its steady climb for years to come. If you get in at 220, you will get great gains in the long term. But if you're looking for the short term, this may not be huge and you might get single digit in the next 3 to 6 months. You may not get this great stock at a lower price than you will probably right now. It might go down a little bit, couple percent down. But what we see from PayPal is profits are rising more than revenues. Then we see deeper presence in the physical world, just like Square. And finally, advances in digital wallet capabilities like investing through its apps and merchant services such as Venmo is going to be innovative. So real quick though, before we continue. So if you could do me a favor and hit that like button to let me know you're enjoying this, it helps me with the YouTube algorithm to get in front of others just like you that can benefit from these well-researched opportunities. Also comment below if you want me to cover something specific, and don't forget to subscribe and, you know, talk to us in the community, whether it's on the Facebook group or down in the comment section. Let's now talk on Square, then we can kind of see where would I put the $1,000 if I had to choose between PayPal or Square, and how would I kind of split it up. I really like how purpose-driven Square is, and I have been a long-term follower of this business and also investor. They have taken care of the customers, suppliers, and investors through the years and how it's grown. Square keeps finding new ways for sellers to reach customers. They release an on-demand delivery capability and gives power to the businesses to roll it out so that they can keep more of their margin, not like DoorDash or Grubhub, which are increasing their fees to merchants, causing mom and pops to close. Yet what really has investors abuzz is Square's peer-to-peer digital payments platform, Cash App. Between the end of 2017 and June 2020, Cash App's monthly active users count has more than quadrupled to 30 million, with approximately 7 million of these using the Cash Card, which is their own debit card. This platform primarily speaks to millennials and Generation Z and allows Square to collect revenues from transfers, merchant fees, and the foreign exchange. My view is that the use of digital payments alternatives like Cash App is gonna increase in 2021 and beyond. But let's talk numbers. Gross payment volumes going through Square's online systems were increased more than 50% year over year during the second quarter. This in turn led to 28% year over year rise in gross profit. The company also reported fantastic Q3 results. As more sellers join in its ecosystems and more people adopt its Cash App, Square only gets stronger. Arguably, the strongest reason to invest in it is that it offers an entire ecosystem of products and services to its business. Look for the company to expand its ecosystems for individuals as well. Square is already moving in that direction with its plans to acquire Credit Karma's tax preparation business. So it's going to do your taxes for you in the foreseeable future sometime. But if a Biden bull market does arrive next year, and perhaps even if it doesn't, I think that Square should make investors significantly richer in the midterm and long term. And there are some small gains in the short term, but not as big as you might get out of volatility at stocks like Airbnb or DoorDash or even Tesla. In my view, Square is still worth considering for those who don't have exposure to it. If Square concentrated a lot of your portfolio in 2020, the gains, then it might be time to trim down and start rebalancing that. But let's go back to the original question. If you had $1,000, how would I play both of these stocks? I believe Square is thriving and it's proven itself as both a pioneer and innovator, and they've executed well by capturing target markets with flair. Q3 results point toward energized growth prospects. While PayPal benefits from acceleration of digital payments due to COVID, and they have new marketplace wins that offset the headwinds from the end of the eBay operating agreement. So also with their launch of the crypto service and intro of QR codes allows consumers now to use PayPal at large national retail stores. So if you don't have a position in either, I would play it 50-50, $500 in Square, $500 in PayPal, in order to get the benefits of the high growth from Square, if you look at their stock price this year, and strong, stable company from PayPal. Over time, you can adjust the proportions. In the end, I would want to rebalance to have 60% in PayPal and 40% in Square. I believe both are going to grow, but Square will grow faster in terms of percentages, not dollar amounts, and that'll give it a more bullish behavior. But PayPal has the larger market size, and they also have the better profit margin of 46% versus Square's 32%. So what do you think? Comment below. And if you want to get my DCF calculator and some of the stocks that I put together, then click that first link in the pinned comments below and also in the description. This is going to take you to my webpage where you can enter your email and I'll instantly send you a simple DCF calculator, my top stock watch list, and also keep you updated on all my videos so you don't miss any. You'll also get dibs into my stock picks before anyone else does. See you on the next one.